ahead.
Elvisi Dusha, 26, born in Albania, raised in London, professional basketball player.
1, 2, 3, Raiders!
My greatest influence, if we're talking athletes, for me would probably have to be Allen Iverson and Kobe Bryant, but definitely Allen Iverson for me. He was a relentless competitor. Nothing ever fazed him, regardless of his size, his height, who he's up against, and I just love that about him. You know, I see a bit of myself in the same situation as him. Life-wise, it'd probably be my family, my two brothers and my mum and dad, if I'm being honest, just because we've had a very different upbringing to other people, even though other people have their own, issues in upbringing. But it'd have to be my family. You know, we motivate each other, we look after each other, and as much as we don't see each other, we are always supportive of one another too. So, yeah. My biggest fear for me would be failure or the fear of not knowing, between them two, if I'm being honest. Failure, because it just doesn't sit well with me. I'd like to think I'm a winner in life, as in the sense of I'm on the right track, and the thought of not being on that track's a bit scary at times, and also the fear of not knowing as well, just not having a clue what's next, not having a clue what's what behind that next door, is a bit, it has me on edge sometimes. So when basketball's all over for me, I haven't given it much thought, because I'd like to think I'm still gonna got a good couple of years behind me, but I have got a few stuff set in plan outside of basketball, if I'm being honest. A lot of stuff with properties with my brother, as well as wanting to start my own academy, which is what I really do probably want to do once I'm done playing, is become a coach, go into coaching, and hopefully just pass down some of the knowledge I've gained over the years. I think I'd be my own coach. I think I'd have my own, I've been fortunate enough to play with so many good coaches, but I think I'd have my own approach to it. I'd have my own strategies and stuff. I definitely steal a lot of plays from teams I've played on, but if I had to pick a coach, I want to pick someone I'd definitely take after. The way I would treat my players, I'll follow after Krino Raftopoulos. The way I coach my team, I'd probably take after a Lloyd Gardner or Paul James or someone. Just how it's strictly business and professional to them. It's straight. We're cool and everything, but when we're playing, you'll play for me, so don't forget that. Yeah. If I had to describe my game, I would say I'm very controlled, composed, and I have a pretty high IQ, as well as being able to make my teammates, get my teammates really engaged in the game, find them open, get them going, and I'm a very team-orientated, pass-first sort of player. Shoot the open threes, make a play if I have to make a play, but I feel like I'm at my best when I'm in control of the team and I'm allowed to, lead from the floor. We're just off the back of a COVID season, which was very different. of course, it was us as players felt very fortunate being able to play, given everything that's happened, you know, around the world. But yeah, it was a very different year without any fans, which was, you know, always going to be a test, especially at home when you need them. But never, you know, we never counted ourselves out, regardless of the situation going on around the world. We were very fortunate to be playing, and I feel like, you know, the club done a great job at ensuring the safety of all of our players and the safety of, you know, opposition teams when they're travelling down to us. It was definitely a year to remember for performance reasons as a team, as well as it being in a pandemic. So I'm sure we'll never forget that season, but it's nice to have that past us now, and it's nice to potentially look forward to, you know, the regrouping of fans and field arenas and stuff. So, you know, it's definitely something to look forward to. With the team, we had a great season. We had a, you know, an historic year, to say the least. We had 33 wins in one season. We'd reached, we'd had like the longest game winning streak that the club's ever had. We've got all the way to a quarterfinal, we've reached the final of the trophy as well, you know. So I'd say overall for Plymouth Raiders, it was a super successful year. Finished not how we wanted to. We ended up being knocked out in the semi-final against the London Lions, which, you know, which is always not how you want a season to end. But you know, it was great. It gave us a lot of hope for the next season. It gave us a lot of opportunities, opened a lot of doors for the club now, you know. So it's nice pass inside. I started feeling pain in my knee towards the end of the season. I'm not sure where it was from or what it come from. I believe it was, you know, a change of direction, probably because I'm too quick. But it was just, you know, I think it came from a sharp movement, something that I'm not used to. And it just happened to happen at the wrong time, if I'm being totally honest. At the beginning, there was phases of me feeling how bad it was. You know, I struggled to sleep. I couldn't lift my leg. Like, driving became a problem, you know, and that's when I started realizing, all right, well, this is some new territory for me. Like, I've never felt this type of pain. I've never not been able to, you know, do certain movements, and all of a sudden I can't right now. So I spent a lot of time with Elliot. He helped me out immensely with preparing for games. I'm not sure what magic tricks he used, but he taped up my knee every game in a way that made me mentally feel like there was absolutely nothing wrong with my knee. Of course, end of the game, all the pain came rushing back. But yeah, I mean, there's loads of just movements that were all new to me that, you know, became painful, and it became the norm eventually because I was so used to it. But, you know, hopefully that'll all be gone soon.
He had a knee arthroscopy and part of his meniscus removed.
I'm just trying to stay positive, if I'm being honest with you. It's quite difficult, you know, not being able to essentially do sports or play basketball, run around, or something as simple as just walk. You know, it's a shame, but, you know, I'm really excited. In terms of time span, I've got no idea where we're at the moment.